Hello everyone, I hope all are safe. Let us begin with the next module, that is unit number 2 as per our syllabus, and this is the final module which need to be covered. So in this particular module we will be discussing about two major topics, that is materials and manufacturing, and also these systems. In materials and manufacturing, the topics are criteria for selecting a material. Like in gas turbine engines, there are different major components and subcomponents which are exposed to different ambient conditions. Some of them are exposed to high temperature conditions, some of them are exposed to high mechanical load conditions. So based on their different conditions, the materials are selected, and which are the other criteria need to be considered are discussed in this particular module. Whereas in the second second topic, that is heat ranges, like for a given metal or for a given material, what are the heat ranges that we will be discussing, and based on the heat ranges or the temperature ranges, where it can be used, that will be discussed. And after that, high temperature strength, that is the strength of a material which will be retained at high temperature as well. So which are those materials and how it can be used at different components or different zone of gas turbine engines are also discussed in this particular module. Then the surface finishing, like why surface finishing is required for the components of a gas turbine engines, and how that surface finishing is going to affect the performance of that particular component are also discussed. Then the powder metallurgy techniques and which components can be fabricated or manufactured using this particular method is discussed. Then the use of composite materials and ceramics. So the use of composite materials and ceramics in gas turbine engines are discussed. And finally, the super alloys which can be used for gas turbine engine turbines are also discussed. How the super alloys are fabricated and why the super alloys are required based on their properties are also discussed. And in the second half of this module, the different systems which are useful in gas turbine engines are discussed, like fuel systems, oil systems are discussed, including their components. Then the sensors used in gas turbine engines and which all the sensors will give us the different data or the parameters from the gas turbine engines are discussed. And after that, how these data from the sensors can be used to control that engines are also discussed. Then the FedEx systems or the FedEx interface between the engine and the controlling parameters. The major one is the fuel control. So how the interface works, even that is discussed. Then the starting of the system, like how exactly the gas turbine engine can be started and what are the different methods of starting a gas turbine engine, including their characteristics, are discussed in this particular module. So to give a brief idea of what will be the included in the second module, are just discussed. Then the first topic, criteria for selection of material, like how exactly we are going to select a particular material in gas turbine engines, are discussed. Like the first one is strength, like how the strength plays a major role in selecting a particular material, which are exposed to, some of them are exposed to creep, some of them are exposed to rupture. So in these different condition, which material we have to select on, and also on what basis. Like the first one, creep, where the mechanical load as well as thermal load will be acting, and in the rupture the loads will be acting from the different planes or from different angles. Now in this particular situation, which type of materials we need to select, so that gives the first criteria, that is strength. Second one is ductility, like the material has to be ductile in nature and also brittle in nature. Like what is the percentage of ductility requirement in that particular material in particular zone of an engine, even that is discussed. So if let us consider one example, like a cowling of an engine. If it is very ductile, then if there is an external impact by a foreign body, then because of it is high ductility, it will change its shape, the aerodynamic shape, completely. And if it is not ductile anymore, if it is totally brittle, then due to that impact the material will fail, or that particular component will fail. So the ductility plays a major role depending upon that. Similarly, the next one is coefficient of expansion or coefficient of thermal expansion. Means when the material is exposed to different temperatures, the material will expand, or the material will change its shape and size. And due to this, the performance of that particular component will be different. For example, if the coefficient of thermal expansion is higher, then when it is exposed to higher temperature, the expansion process will be faster and the design will be different, and due to that the performance what we get out of that particular turbine will be different. So the material should have a sufficient amount of thermal expansion, and as well as it shouldn't have a large amount of thermal expansion. Then the thermal conductivity, which will be basically used to have a cooling process. For example, if the combustor liner are not thermally conductor, the materials what we used doesn't have a good thermal conductivity, then the cooling process of those liners will not be done continuously, which leads to the failure of that particular liner. Similarly, the turbine blades as well as the afterburner section. So the thermal conductivity should be good, so such that the cooling process will be continuous. So based on that, we decide the material. Then the corrosion and also oxidation. Like if we are considering a compressor, in that case, when there is another method of thrust augmentation, that is water and methanol mixture injection, and due to this water injection, there will be corrosion process and there will be oxidation process, and due to that the material which we use for a compressor will start corroding, will start changing its design. So due to that, the performance of the compressor will vary, the strength of that compressor will vary. So the material what we select should have a good corrosion resistance, good oxidation resistance. Then the melting point and critical temperatures. Like if the melting point of the material is very small, then it will change its shape suddenly if the temperature rises. The critical temperature is nothing but the maximum temperature water material can take, and if it goes beyond that, then again it will change its shape as well as size. So the maximum temperature what we can have in an engine is at the turbine section or at the combustor exit section. Now if the material is not good enough or doesn't have a higher melting point, then it will change its shape, which will completely change the performance of that particular subcomponents, which leads to a bad performance from the engine, nothing but the lower thrust. Then the last criteria, which is very important, is thermal shock resistance, which means if there is a hot spot in a combustor, and due to that hot spot, particular hot spot, the material property will be changing, and due to that changing material properties, again the performance what we can get from that particular hot spot zone will be different. And when we have this hot spot, when there is improper combustion or when there is a fuel deposition at that particular zone, or this swirlers what we can have, which creates a vortices, and those vortices nothing but the combustion zones are located at only one place instead of moving from that, that leads to hot spot. Now other parameter for a thermal shock is the thermal choking. Like if there is a choking going on thermally, then that leads to sudden rise in temperature, nothing but sudden rise in entropy as well, leads to thermal shocks. And the material should be good thermal shock resistance, then only the material or the design of that particular component will be retained, and hence the performance can be maintained for a certain period of time, depends on the life what we are going to calculate. So these are the basic criteria which needs to be followed or which need to be considered before we select a material in a gas turbine engine. So in the next video, we'll cover the next topic related to the second module. I hope this is clear. If you have any doubts, please let me know. Thank you. Stay safe.